instigated outside section, that error is inadmissible. That court also heard holding that the conviction in this case was based solely on circumstantial evidence. As we have found, the first response act of leading this important man to the basketball club, of course, when the RDX explosive was dug out, was an admission of a material fact which, coupled with the circumstantial evidence of the court, seems the response guilty. In the circumstances, we find that this appeal does indeed have merit, and we accordingly allow it. My brother, I just received and received the reading of the presenting presentations. Yes. I'm sure that those who commit or plan to commit terrorist offenses do not escape punishment. In this case, the trial court found that although the golf course was open and unfenced, the respondent's visit at least twice to hold an appliance in that golf course was not coincidental, but was a testimony of people who had a purpose at that particular spot. On consideration of the entire evidence of the court, the trial court concluded that the first respondent indeed led this officer where the RTS was recovered, leaving it with no option but to draw inference that the respondents either planted or previewed the planting of the explosive weapon to come. On appeal, upon re-evaluation of the evidence of record, any court appealed was the decision. However, in further appeal, the court of appeal held that, quote, from the evidence on record, golf course was not fenced, landed, and that it was possible for any member of the public to have entered it and placed the RDA where it was found. The provisions of sections 25A, 111.1, and 119 of the Evidence Act, thus arising at 110 of the Criminal Code. Particulars of that offense were that all not before the 20th of June 2012, ambassador force alone had been applied in Mombasa, municipality of Mombasa County. Jointly with others not before the court, the respondents put an explosive substance, namely cyclone, treatment, it's a wrong name, RBX. At the same golf course, with intent to force grievous harm to the golf players. Count two, the operation to commit a felony contrary to section 301 of the Penal Code. The particulars being that on or before the 20th of June 2012, Mombasa Municipality within Mombasa County, jointly with others not before the court, they were found armed with 15 kilograms of RDX in circumstances that indicated that they were so armed with the intent to commit a felony, namely causing grievous harm. And three, that being in possession of explosives, contrary to Section 29 of the Explosive Act, Chapter 115, also again, the particulars being names that the Iran offers our engines. They, however, were checked out of that hotel on the 16th June 2012, after 5 days. days, do not be by the state, lyco, regency, exhale for 3 days. When I think of June 2012, why don't I wait for the global number of national airports? The final is the fellow, being to appeal, to justify the matter as being general public importance. In the petition, the fellow seeks orders, the judgment of the court of appeal, delivered in Nairobi on the 26th of January 2018. Criminal appeal number 135 of 2016 be set aside in the order of acquittal of the respondents issued by that court be reversed and the application by the trial court upheld. This is the situation before the black head magistrate. Period not exceeding 5 days, you should pay a fine not exceeding 500,000 shillings for good for any offense. The Supreme Court shall have the same power and authority as the High Court to punish any person in contempt of court in any case within subsection 1-5. Nothing in subsections 1-3 shall limit or affect the power and authority referred to in subsection 4. End of quote. There is no doubt that an act in contempt of the court constitutes an affront to the judicial authority. And the court has the liberty and empowerment to meet out penalty for such conduct in a proper case. The object is firstly to vindicate the court's authority, secondly, to uphold honorable conduct among others in their standing as officers of the court, and thirdly, to safeguard its processes for assuring compliance so as to sustain the rule of law and the administration of justice. With us in this instance, making plain that counsel shall not engage in such course of conduct as is depicted in this ruling. And any report in that regard in the future, shall occasion contempt of court proceedings with the inevitable consequences, and if not, then appropriate sanctions for contempt in the face of the court. This is the order of the court in this question. All the offending paragraphs of written submissions of senior counsel Mr. Abdullahi are set out in paragraph 2 of this ruling. Shall not remain as part of the record of the Supreme Court and shall forthwith be expanded and wholly obliterated in the record of the Supreme Court. This is the decision of the court in its ruling.
Yes, my lord. Can I introduce counsel?
Yes, you are done.
Very good, yes. I appear with my
where the court is acting as a surrogate for the state to legitimize the illegal and unlawful detention of the respondent, end of quote. Two, again from the onset, we wish to state in the most emphatic manner that the court is biased against the respondents, lacks impartiality, and a very minimum ingredient of independence from the state and its agents, in this case, is upset. The court had previously based its decision on extraneous political factors and considerations that are underpinned by a nationalistic affinity between the court and the state, end of quote. Three, this court is a jurisprudential train wreck. It is incoherent. It is unpersuasive. It is unfaithful to the Constitution and is churning out constitutional interpretations that are not, that are best counterfeit, end of quote. Four, what? This court sees no limits to its jurisdiction and power. Its jurisdiction is infinite and interminable. It can hear and determine anything on earth. How can a court that does as it thinks, imagines, wishes, hopes, correctly interpret the Constitution and deliver justice to the parties before it? Question mark. That is simply impossible. This court has been wins and is incapable of doing justice according to the court. Now, on his terms as an officer of the court, he conducted himself in a disgraceful and reprehensible manner. In admission to the bar, all advocates make an affirmation as officers of the court. Section 15.4 of the Deputies Act provides that an aspiring advocate court shall take an oath or make an affirmation as an officer of the court before the Chief Justice in such form as he shall require and shall thereafter sign the roll in the presence of the registrar or the deputy registrar, which shall have the signature of the student's end of the court. The status of an advocate as an officer of the court is expressly provided for in section 55 of the Advocates Act. An advocate, consequently, bears an obligation to promote the cause of justice and the due functioning of the constitutionally established judicial process, ensuring that the judicial system functions efficiently, effectively, and in a respectable manner. In that context, advocates bear the ethical duty of telling the truth in court while insisting from any negative conduct such as dishonesty or discourtesy. The overriding duty on the advocate, the court, as section 17 of the Act says, quote, the President may grant a letter of confirmation to any person of irreproachable professional conduct who has rendered exemplary service to the legal and public service in care, confirming upon him the rank and dignity of senior counsel. That of this Act, section 17.2, sets out the requisite qualification of senior counsel. Candidates should be an advocate of at least 15 years standing. Being one through section 10 of that applies, is to hold and should have held for a continuous duration of at least 15 years, one for other qualifications specified in section 13 of the Act. Section 18.1 provides role of senior counsel. All advocates bearing the rank of senior counsel are required to sign this role for section 18. the designation of senior counsel is a recognition of outstanding status for the bearer and symbolizes the identification of those advocates whose achievement and standing invokes the expectation that they are in a position to render distinguished service as advocates and counselors in the course of due and meritorious administration